Okay, let's take a look at the default layout of Blender. Before I get started, it's important to know that I am working in Blender 2.8, specifically 2.82. Blender 2.8 was a massive overhaul to the software. It brought it up to a lot of different industry standards. It changed around how like selection is done, the different key maps, and it changed the layout a lot. This is important because if you're looking to learn Blender more in depth, you need to find tutorials that were created after August 2019, which is when this update occurred. So with that, once you've opened it up, you'll probably see something like this. You can just select a new general file and then have a look around. So there is a lot going on when you first open it up, but basically you can break it down into these different window panes. So the main one we're looking at right now is the viewport, and this is showing you all of the different objects that you're working on in your scene. Right now, I just have Blender's default cube. This will contain its own menus for things like adding in primitives, which are just the basic meshes, like the cubes that you can work from. Some tools you'll lose a lot, like moving, and then different options for display. So viewport is where you'll be working a lot, but then you've got these other panes like the outliner, which just lists all the objects you have in your scene, and the properties tab, which lets you change lots of different properties for any object that you have selected. So the way Blender is set up, you'll get this default layout of these panes, but you can actually customize how they're laid out. So if you want to add a new window, you just go down into one of the corners. So I could go right here, or I could go right here, anywhere these little crosshairs appears, and you can just click and drag. There we go. Click and drag, and you'll see I just had another viewport appear. And if I go in the upper left corner, I can actually change what this window is. And you'll notice now that this is in all of the upper left corners of these different panes I'm working on. So if I wanted this to be like the properties tab, I could change it to that. If I wanted it to be something else like the timeline, which is used for animation, I can change it to that. And then I can just get rid of it by dragging down until that arrow appears. So those different panes will change depending on what sort of thing that you're doing. And you'll notice all these tabs up here are basically different layouts of the different window panes that you can have specific to different tasks you might do in Blender. So some common ones a paleontologist might expect to do could be something like modeling or sculpting, which are two different ways to work on and change the shape of your 3D model. Animation, if you want to create like just a simple spinning video, or maybe something more complex like a walk cycle. And then rendering, which is how you produce the final product of an image or video. Some of these other things you're not going to be using nearly as much, like UV editing, texture paint, and shading are all much more so for if you want to get really fancy with your materials and textures on top of your model. Scripting is if you want to do any sort of Python scripting with Blender. And then compositing is more so for combining with external video and that kind of thing. There are also all these other options, including video editing, which I have found useful. The video editor in Blender is simple, but works surprisingly well. The final thing you'll notice is just these typical file edit menus up here, and kind of the most important things in here are the import and export in the file menu, and then the application preferences, which are in the edit menu.